We've got some updates for you from Governor Inslee's press release yesterday. We'll talk parking enforcement and some things you can do to help the heavily taxed medical community during these times. Thanks for joining us for West Seattle Daily episode number 53, brought to you by SeaTown Real Estate. I'm your host, Christian Harris. So here's some of the latest updates from around West Seattle. First, we want to start off by thanking Kerri, Ann, and Christie of the West Seattle Life Instagram page for this tip. Join your West Seattle friends and neighbors in a sing-along this Saturday, April 4th at 7 p.m. We don't need to be socially isolated in times like these. We can connect by doing something collectively as a community while still staying safe. We'll be singing Times Like These by Foo Fighters. Hope you can throw open a window or stand in your yard and join us for the sing-along. And so here's some COVID-19 updates. During yesterday's press conference from Governor Jay Inslee, he said, "What we have done so far is not enough. Orders out of the Fed aren't being fulfilled quickly enough, so we need to seize our own destiny, as the state did back in World War II. So he's asking all business people, all skilled workers, and all leaders to ask themselves if they could change what they were making now, and instead make what's needed. This is a moment that counts. If you can, go to coronavirus.wa.gov and sign up to help." He also gave guidance to mortgage companies to try and find ways to help mortgage holders. He also notes that 130 Washington National Guard members are mobilized to help food banks across the state, in many cases replacing volunteers who need to stay home because they are in at-risk groups. Then he went on to acknowledge that our social distancing efforts in Washington are working pretty well, even better than they are in some other states. But he says we can't let up now, so it will be quite likely that the stay-at-home order will be extended, though he says he's not ready to make that announcement just yet, more likely in the next few days. On another note, if you're overloaded on hand sanitizer and have an unopened bottle to share, there will be a bin set inside the door of Easy Street Records to collect those donations. As they explained on their Instagram page, it is for neonatal intensive care nurses. 8-ounce bottles of gel are preferred, not spray. Make sure they're not expired. The bin will be accessible from 7 a.m. till noon daily through Sunday. It's worth noting that Easy Street Cafe remains open for takeout, and they've also been doing personal deliveries by the owner Matt Vaughn and his son Archie. You may have heard some chatter around town about parking enforcement issues. Some parking enforcement has been suspended, but not all. The West Seattle blog has sent the mayor's office a question last week on behalf of a reader who thought that getting a ticket in a 2-hour parking zone just east of a mostly closed off business district was a bit harsh, considering that everyone is under orders to stay home. The city reiterated today that while it's changing some parking policies, mainly suspending the 72-hour parking limit in residential neighborhoods because of the COVID-19 pandemic, it's still enforcing most parking rules. Food and COVID-19. While we want to remain cautious, we don't want to stray into paranoia. The FDA is reiterating that there is no evidence to suggest that COVID-19 is spreading through food, nor through takeout orders, groceries, or produce. When you return home from your grocery store, please thoroughly wash your hands, but there's no reason to try and disinfect your groceries. And please, for the love of God, don't put disinfectant chemicals like household cleaners on your food that you're going to eat. Speaking of groceries, agriculture and food production are also considered essential activities. This is to make sure food continues to fill our grocery stores and food banks. Deliveries to grocery stores are continuing and steady, and farmers, ranchers, and food processors are producing plenty for our needs. There's no need to worry about shortages and no need to stock up other than to make sure you don't have to leave your house more than once a week if possible. Let's also practice compassion and thoughtfulness. While you're out doing your once-a-week grocery shopping, if there's something you can pick up for someone else or for a neighbor who maybe cannot leave the house, leave a bag on the porch, ring the bell, and then run back to your side of the road and wave. And this weekend, if you have a little bit of time on your hands, try knocking out some of those home projects. The West Seattle Tool Library will be open Saturday and Sunday from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. to rent out those tools you may not have yourself. And as a thought, have you pulled out your board games and puzzles recently? Now that we're just over officially a week into this stay home, stay healthy mandate, what are you doing to maintain your sanity? Have you played every board game, done every puzzle? Have you watched everything on Netflix already? Leave your comment. Let us know what you are doing to stay sane. Don't forget to subscribe to this podcast or enable it on your Alexa device. Thanks for joining us, and we'll talk to you tomorrow.